yesterday, one of the masses, we had over 800 people. And it just blew me away. I know before mass, and just kind of looking around at the church and how beautiful it looked and how they decorated it up beautifully. And this little kiddo was maybe 7, 8 years old, standing in that church and the children's pageant was coming, getting ready. He was there to practice. And he said, "Hey, Father Goebel, is that Jesus up there?" And I said, "Yes, that's where he's supposed to be. And they're going to put him in the wings there a little later." "Oh, no, no, no. I meant up there in the star." They had a nice star on the table. I said, "Why do you say that?" "Well, didn't Jesus come to kind of explain things to all of us?" I thought that was really cool. Really spoke to me of what really the basic message of Christmas is all about. There's a first reason for it. Blessed are the free to the one who came to tell us the good news. What's the good news? What's the good news for all of us? It's me. You remember the first time that you woke up in the morning when you were a little kid and you came downstairs and you saw everything under the tree? Remember that? That was good news. All those gifts. Now you go around and not only here in the church building, but in the neighborhood, in your own homes, I'm sure. Decorated with lights. Terrific. Boy, that's really amazing. But you know, my friends, it's all a trap. It's a trap that diverted our attention. We have to kind of be aware of that. And we need someone to kind of show us. So that when we look at Christmas lights, we'll be able to get through them all and recognize that Jesus came as a baby, yes. He came to show us, enlighten us. Ah, but he came. Is he still here? Number two, the great mystery is beginning to unfold what the good news is, that the baby Jesus didn't come just once. He's been here ever since. In our lives. In our thoughts. And all that we say and do, we're the only religion that says that. That Jesus is constantly with us. You know he's with us not only when we do good things. You know that Jesus is with us even when we sin. He doesn't get up and walk out of the room. He's still with us. He doesn't leave us. Part of the good news is for us to recognize our way in following him. You know, we have a wonderful devotion. We look at the mystery of the creation. You know, one of the great mysteries is Mary. But God did something. Allowed a virgin to give birth. God did that. It's part of the good news to all of us. Nothing is impossible for God. Part of that realization is filtered into our lives and today. In our lives. Yeah, we can sit back and say, "Oh, all the problems and all the worries and all the tragedies." Jesus is with them, just as he is with us, every single day and every single moment of our lives. And that's the great good news. Jesus doesn't leave. For us to realize that in our lives, every day, every moment, every single second of our life is something that is glorious to God. Because he uses us. Uses everything we do. You think about that, we let that become a part of our life. How can I say it differently? Why God is working. That reality is kind of moment that helps us as we move ahead limpingly along in our journey of following after the Lord Jesus Christ. Nothing is impossible for God. Proved that with the virgin birth. He proved that by letting the shepherds see the angels. He proved that by sending his son to not only die for us, but to keep us from ourselves. Nothing is impossible for God. The message of Christmas is exactly